like a deep vulnerability from just arriving here. My daughter, Atlas, her middle name is Oaks. And so that there's so many oak trees on this land makes me feel right at home. I am just enamored right now, taking it all in. So much to see, so many plant friends, so many tree allies, so much medicine, so much wilderness and realness. Oh, I just want to bathe in it.
Who's gonna leave early, so swiftly?
With momhood, there's so little time that you get to yourself. On June 1st, we left Bisbee. We traveled all the way up through Arizona, then through Nevada, and then finally into California. Almost to Mount Shasta. It's about an hour and a half away. We're just needing a little pee break and a little stretching break. But the first thing that Atlas says is, "What's that smell?" And it's the woods!
Smells like the woods!
As we were taking the drive up here, when we finally hit California and I could see some of the hills, I could see the hills covered with trees, my heart just felt like it came back into my chest. I suddenly felt my pulse again. And we are here in Southern Oregon. We have finally arrived and it's absolutely gorgeous.
I love you, babe, but I don't know why.
We're living off-grid in a yurt. We have a shitter outside and running on solar power with propane stove for cooking and propane fridge, but we have a wood stove for the nights and the morning. Even though it's June, the mornings and nights are pretty chilly for us. We just came from Arizona, so we're gonna acclimate. I think it will acclimate pretty quickly. The days are really blazing hot though. It's about 90 degrees today. Up here it's probably a little cooler than down in town. We're 25 minutes from the town, Ashland. It's a really sweet little town. It's the home of the Oregon Shakespeare Festival, and I'm so grateful for that place. It's unlike most middle America. It doesn't have the box stores or the fast food chains, and it's really artsy, and there's a lot of earth lovers here. So I've lived here before, but coming to it now, I have a whole new perspective. I took this leap of faith and I started packing up all our stuff down there, and we quit our jobs, and the idea was just to go be in nature and then see where it would lead us. This magical place appeared and we were allowed to come here and live here. So now, instead of just being weekend warriors or kind of struggling along camping, not knowing the next step, we've landed.
I was gonna die young. Now I gotta wait for you.
This can you say? We're home.
Can it capture a gizzard? A real one?
Absolutely. Let's go find one.
People would weep, how tragic, so early.
Grasshoppers?
We captured both of them.
Two mosquitoes can't get me. I also can't.
He hopped. There's a lot of work to do still. I think that anytime you make such a huge transition, there's a lot of work to do. We still have tons of stuff to do in the yurt. There's this whole patch of garden space that will be, you know, worked eventually. I look up at the hills and my front yard and my side yard and my backyard are the woods now. Fresh spring water. We have a creek right in front of the yurt and woods for days. Everything backed up. All this land behind me here is the Cascade Siskiyou National Monument. So it's just the national forest and tons of trails, but mostly just the wilderness. And I finally feel right at home. I think that the process of change for Atlas was really huge. Because Taylor and I, we're familiar with these woods, and she was born here in Oregon, but she's, for the past years, lived in Arizona in the desert, and so the first couple nights there was a lot of grief, and she really missed our old house. But I knew that if we could just be really present with her and expose her to the woods and just to the stream and to the trees and outdoors, that she would just be purified of all of that. And just like that, she's just really, really happy. With the move, it's just been absorbed, the change. So we haven't had screen time. We've gotten off cane sugar. We're just on natural sugars now. And it's only been a week, and now she's already so much more calm and present and excited to explore. The first couple days here, she didn't really want to leave the yurt that much, and she was pretty shy around the kids. And now this morning, she just was like, got her gear ready, and we were going to go hunting for mushrooms. Something that's really cool, one of the reasons why we moved to Arizona was because Taylor's mom lived down there, but also our old house that we were living in a few towns away from here, it was sold to a developer, and so we had to move. But on that land, I had had a little urban flower farm, and so we went back, and all of the buildings have been completely demolished, and nothing has been built on it yet. There's just the weeds, and the earth has taken over. But I got to look around, and some of the flowers were still there. So I got some of the dried flowers, or some of the flowers that dry really well. I picked them. And I also transplanted some hollyhocks, one of my favorite flowers. And it was so nice to see that they were one of the ones surviving plants. So I transplanted them. We'll see how they do. You never know with transplants. But they're in the sun now. I've kind of put them in a shady area. I'm just a little piece of the past. We got to bring it here, and it was the first flowers I got to plant in this ground, so it felt good, because before I'd never got to see them bloom. We had to move before I got to see them bloom, and so now I can see them bloom and bring a little bit here into this new home as we start this new chapter.
I could have missed it, I never knew. Chain reaction, but you're holding the fuse.
I do have a Patreon account set up. If you want to support this sharing, please go check it out. I will be hopefully doing a couple videos a week. I'm gonna aim for two. We'll see if I can get one in. I think it really all depends on time, and I know that both of us still need to be doing some income work. Even though we're out here, we gotta get by.
But now I gotta wait around and watch you.
To raise my daughter in the woods. Oh goodness. I get to raise myself here. So much is changing. So much has changed. I can just see by some of the plants that I know here that there's going to be deep healing, deep transformation, and all of the support needed for it. So day by day, step by step, I can plunge into the waters whenever I want. Thank you.
Well, sometimes I wonder, oh, what am I ever gonna do? Gonna live out my life until the very last day is through.
I can't wait
wait to show you the dogs. When I first saw them, Muna and Tui, when they came up, those are my first tears. Because I was in a bit of a shock, and it was a couple days before they actually came down to say hello from their spot up on the hill, and they're just so massive and so beautiful and so friendly, and I'm so glad they're here. I am so inspired by this place. There's gonna be months and years of recording different things. There's so much I haven't even said. There's on this land, there's an outdoor shower, a cedar hot tub, a nice little swimming punch. There's cabin here, a really sweet couple. They have ducks and goats, and then there's a wood shop and a communal area. We have workaway people come and help them with their alternative structures. They're building a straw bale up on the hill by the house, another house. There's also a really gorgeous straw bale, or a really gorgeous cob house that's going to be made into a retreat, a dark retreat. So kind of like an isolation, sense deprivation, inward journey for people to kind of self-initiate themselves in the stillness and the silence and the darkness. There is also a Mongolian yurt with and a teepee where a couple live with their three kiddos, the three girls. There's another teepee where a workaway person has lived for quite a while, and another like teepee tent over here. And Taylor and Atlas are just now driving in. I haven't mentioned much about Taylor, but it's so amazing to see him out here because this is his element. He grew up in a very similar situation, so he's barely spent much time in the yurt at all. He's just out here like tinkering away with wood and making little structures, and he's just in his zen. And it's taken me a little while because I'm so particular about my space, but I'm grateful that I have a lot of time now. One thing is I'm doing my very best not to jump right back into waitressing, because I've had a lot of my life I've not had the stablest of income, and I've learned that I really do love and appreciate a stable income, especially now with a child. But I'm going to be leaping into the unknown, similarly to how I leaped into the unknown with just like following the urge to be in the wild, following the feeling, wanting to be out here and live out here. And I leapt and I was caught like in this wonderland of wilderness.
So let the sun keep on rising and the moon keep on rising too.
From an egg, and I don't know what kind of creature I am yet.
I was gonna die young.